Hi guys, this is Alan. I'm just here to try to introduce you to a fun place to spend your time over the holidays. That fun place is codinggame.com. So basically all you have to do is to go there, log in if you already have an account or sign up. I'll pretend to sign up here. And you can just use whatever favorite thing you have. Of course that would be GitHub. So you go in and you authorize GitHub and you authorize Coding Game on GitHub. And now you're in, and you can start having fun with code. So essentially what you can do in here is you can practice and go through a bunch of different puzzles, or you can compete against other coders real time, or you can learn new stuff as well. You can of course also contribute and add more competitions to it. It's always a great way to get started just by doing some puzzles. And they are divided into easy puzzles, medium, hard, very hard. And really, it starts with the stuff anybody can figure out, and it ends up with the building your own AI to compete with other AIs in order to solve the goal here. Tons and tons of puzzles. In this one here, you can take one. And when you're in one of them here, you will basically read about what is the challenge that you want to achieve in this puzzle, and then you can start solving the puzzle. And basically you get to choose which language you want to use for coding the solution in. You could pick JavaScript for instance, and then it'll come with a preset of information that'll give some input information, and over here you'll understand what you get as input, and you'll also understand what you need to produce as output. So pretty much every competition in here is about getting some input, doing something, and then producing some output. And some of the more advanced stuff, you actually have games that'll call a certain method multiple times, and you have to produce different output for every time, and so on. But in this case, it's very easy. You get some input, you do some juggling to that, and you figure out the answer, and you print it out, and it'll work. And once you've done that, you can start running through the test cases. And that for each scenario, there's a bunch of test cases, and you can kind of play the test case, and it'll measure if the output based on the input matches up. And of course, in this case, it didn't change anything, so it doesn't match up. You can also output debug messages using, in this case, print error. And then you get the output out as debug messages. So this is a fairly easy way to start coding and just trying to solve some different puzzles. My favorite language is C sharp, but you can pretty much pick what you want and just try to play all this again. Once you complete all the test cases, you can submit your answer and then it'll test it a bit further, and then you might get the answer accepted. With the puzzles here, you can take as long time as you want and just try to understand them and solve them, and it's really fun way to get into coding and try to see how can I figure out a solution to this and this given question. And of course also try more and more difficult puzzles as you go along. Once you get a bit of hang of how it all works, then it's really fun to start competing. And if you look at the competing, there's of course a lot of really big contests. There are new contests, I think it's every month. There are bot programming contests, as I mentioned before, where you actually have to code a bot that will act on your behalf and solve some kind of quest or some kind of puzzles. Some of them, I don't remember if this is the one here, will actually, yeah, I think this is the one, will actually be with some different sets of bots that will fly around, and you have to create some code that will actually manage and control your bot. Here you can actually see, because you can of course in these puzzles here, these contests, you can actually go back in and you can work on your code that you've done earlier, and you can kind of run your code and you can see what actually happens with it. And then you can submit it and you can compete with your code against other bots that other people wrote. So you can actually run through it and you can see what actually happens. Now you actually see what is my bot doing here and how does it act against some other ones. I don't even remember the specific case I'm supposed to solve here. I think it's about moving between the different numbers in the right order as fast as possible and changing the gas and direction as efficiently as possible. And so you kind of get an idea about how it's going, and then you can later submit it and compete against others and figure out how your bot working out compared to the other bots. So that's fun. Sometimes when you know, you just want to relax a bit and have a quick bit of fun, then going back to compete and checking out the clash of code is a really fun way. That's also fun to do with others if you're at a party or something like that. You can join a clash of code. I'm not going to... I'll try one here, but let me just explain what they're about first. So basically you have three different modes of clash code competitions. One is that you have to be the fastest one to deliver, to solve a puzzle and deliver the solution. And of course the solution should work. It should meet all the test cases. In some competitions it's about writing the shortest piece of code. Now my favorite language is C#. That's not ideal for this competition because C# is quite verbose, so you have a lot of code to write. JavaScript would probably be a lot better, or Python, to win this kind of competition, because here you're measured on the number of characters in your code. Finally, there's the last one, which is the reverse, where you have to see a bunch of test cases and then figure out what are you supposed to do to achieve these tests. So. And you have to figure it out, because there will be other test cases than just the ones shown that you have to then deliver the proper output or the proper algorithm for. So, but we can just try to join one here. I don't think I'm going to win, because I'm going to talk and explain while I do it, but just for the fun of it, joining a clash, and then you join in, and you basically wait for enough people to be in the clash. I was the only one, so it didn't really work out. We'll see a few more are starting here. And either when all the players' slots are filled, or when the time runs out, it will start a clash of code. And you can of course also chat with the other people in the clash while you're at it. Actually, I think maybe we can launch it now. I get the option to launch clash. Here we go. So in this case, it's about passing the maximum number of tests as fast as possible. Okay, let's try that. So you must print true or false if you have enough paint to cover the whole inner surface of the house. The paint stock is Q, so in the variable Q in liters, and there are N rooms in the house. We assume that 1 liter paint will cover 5 square meters. In each room, walls, floors, and ceiling must be painted with one layer. Don't mind about doors and windows, paint them all. So that's an interesting challenge here. So basically what do we get in? We get the paint stock in liters as Q. We have that already prepared in the code for us here. The number of rooms to be painted, N. And again, I apologize, I use C#, but it really would be similar in JavaScript, I guess, where you're just reading in this kind of input. And then the next lines, X, Y, Z, the room dimensions in meters. Great. You should output true if you have enough paint to cover the whole inner surface, false if not. So this is a question of going through every single room. We have N rooms, and for every single room we have X, Y, Z, so we need to figure out, do we have enough paint to paint them all? So I guess this is a matter of counting the number of square meters. I apologize for solving this in C#, but I guess you'll get the point. And then we basically aggregate it. So we have one room here with the dimension X, Y, and Z. And let's see, we have the floor and the floor would be X times Y. And we also have the ceiling, don't mind about doors and windows, paint them all. Walls, floor, ceiling must be painted. So we assume that we have times 2, because we have both the floor and we have the ceiling. we also need to consider the walls. So there's two walls and the x width times the height. Obviously, I'm doing a mistake because the parameters were uppercase. And I assume we also have two opposing walls on the y. So something like this. And so we're basically aggregating all of this. And we were assuming 1 liter of paint would cover 5 square meters. So with 2 liters of paint, total grids available would be the 5 liters per square meter times Q. So basically we want to return true if that amount is larger than or equal to the number of square meters, if I understand this one correctly. Return return a boolean with total coverage available is larger or equal to square meter count. Something like this. Now we are returning that actually maybe we need to output stuff. Yeah, so we shouldn't actually return stuff. In this case, we should output it. So in C sharp, that's console.write. Like this. We might even just go like this. And then toString. Let's see here. Ah, we wrote false, but it's expected to be in lowercase. So I will just modify that one like this. Bingo. Now, does it all work? We play all the test cases. We played all the test cases. Let's submit it. And there we go. I played this one. I had 100% score. I didn't go as fast as the first one, though, but I was talking while I was doing it, so I guess that's my excuse here. Others were faster to submit, but didn't get a full score. And then there's the little one left clashing. That's kind of cool. You can also decide to share my code so others can see how did we actually solve this sharing the code. Play again or go back to home. That's a fun and easy example of how you can actually try to put yourself under a bit of pressure and get the more familiar coding. Of course, I use C#. Feel free to use whatever language you prefer. JavaScript works just as well in here. That's it for me. Have a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays.